Now, the first major issue I have with Borderlands 3, it has to be the diversity of dialogue that your main protagonist could say throughout the game. Now, to be fair, yes, it was an evasive concept if you were willing to have your character talk in-game. However, in execution, is not really too well. Put into perspective, there's no inch of emotion going on in each feature of what cutscenes they hold. And yes, it is quite awkward to see this so go bad, as the NPCs you meet throughout the game does have verse of content into them, have the characterization and reference they make throughout the game is just very well done. To be fair, the ints of our main protagonists we have do have their moments in certain scenes, but that's the main thing that bothers me. I don't want it to be just famous until one scene, I want it to be famous throughout most of every scene. When it comes to the education of graphics throughout most generation in video games, Borderlands 3 is a great exception to that fact. Now, keep in mind, Borderlands 2 was beloved for the heavy tints of graphics and bright numerous colors throughout Borderlands, and though Borderlands 3 took it to a new extent, and the versatile combat and sound design throughout most of the game is beyond phenomenal, to the guns, to the animations, and including my favorite, the intrigue of the atmosphere around the entire geography of the galaxy. And though the world could get somewhat flat, it is recommendable that the architecture around any building you come across, it is fairly is structural accurate beyond regards. It actually looks like it's going to be able to hold up. Fair in mind, to most developers' eyes, buildings are not too much important if you're not able to go inside of them, but to me, I could see Gearbox to the proper and natural time into the atmosphere and architecture and backgrounds you can see throughout the game, so at least you didn't get lazy on that effect. Some would either say that was pretty irrelevant with the active buildings, but guys, the little things you can see in video games that do look good, it naturally proves how dedicated they are bringing this game into a real life effect. And we can never forget about the AI throughout most companions you can meet throughout the game. It actually looks like they've been through hell, how much gunfights they've been through, and it actually looks like different people we have not seen during the few games before here. So yeah, they did a lot more research and a time and effort and artwork into the character models themselves.
Now, like every other RPG, the main goal you can have when it comes to leveling up and having a challenge are the boss fights. And the Borderlands series is a great effect when it comes to the acknowledgement of boss fights. Typically, yes, in Borderlands 2, it was rather hard of a challenge, including with sub-bosses you could find around side missions, but with Borderlands 3 is nothing but half-risk reskins of other mobs you could typically fight around the map. Now, occasionally, that isn't really a bad thing. RPGs have done it all the time, The Witcher 3 has done it, World of Warcraft has done it, and I think I've seen a couple more games have done it in the past, but well in execution. And Borderlands 3 is a great exception if you want to prove too much is a bit too much. Now, yes, the boss fights are well-drawn, they're very world animated when it comes with the act of their fighting scenes and animations with their guns. The true major downside to this is that compare this to Borderlands 2. In Borderlands 2, every boss had his frequent challenges, disadvantage, and advantages. That was the main quote of fun when it came to the act of Borderlands 2, working together as a community to make your lives easier to any boss fight to your wake. In Borderlands 3, they're typically too easy, or unless they're a bit unfair. Many people pointed out, including me acknowledging it, it turns out that most boss fights in here have occasionally a move that are unable to be dodged. And if you think that's able not to be too hard, guess what? That's their ultimate move, by the way. Imagine that, them using their ultimate move at the same time, able to take down your shields and health, and you have to fight them all over again. It only points out that these bosses were rushed and so much that they were so desperate to bring so much difficulty into the boss fight, they just had to add in these key moves for you to have a harder time with him. That is pretty ridiculous and lazy. Now, legendaries in all RPGs are considered a concept you have to get if you're willing to do the amount of DPS you can to take down enemies, and like obviously, Borderlands 3 is a great exception on that behalf. Now, don't get me wrong, active skins in Borderlands 2 are quite amazing on their own, but not typically to the human eye when it comes to the average of most legendaries throughout the game, and on some points, I don't feel like they try either with the skins, only with the base of damage, including what they hold with the added perks. That is not really a bad thing as I see it beyond my eyes. However, in Borderlands 3 is a bit more superior, how they put more effort of the critique of design on each feature of the gun, including having major pop culture references to the idol of the gun. It just makes it a bit more easier to remember it by, and by all regards, they do have a better unique design than Borderlands 2 hold. Now, like I said, yes, Borderlands 2 guns were amazing, I'll never forget them, however, Borderlands 3's legendary skins are a bit more easier and more better to get.
Now, frequent to Borderlands 3, active story and dialogue and throughout everything I have said good about the game is something I still stand by. Now, the instinct of what pushed me off the edge when it came to Borderlands is the active ending. Do not worry, I'm not going to be spoiling you anything. I'll let you enjoy the game the way how you see it. But honestly, guys, the way how you conceive to go to the ending and listen to the credits and what people go through, you start to think of one thing. Now what? That's it. Nothing else. There's so many questions unexplained by many people, and how I felt like it could have been so much better at that point. And bearing in mind, guys, the only reason I would think for them to put it this way is the equal way how to sell DLC, or mostly for the next sequel of Borderlands. You guys are just gonna have to trust me what's going around during the ending, and how much stuff could have been fixed, and so much better. Now guys, like I said, Borderlands 3 is not a terrible game, not even close, but I felt like the game could have been so much better. I just felt like it was too rushed, some bosses didn't know how to be buffed, nerfed. Active dialogue with your character could have been so much better and critiqued of what they go through. Having true emotion with the people you see go away or either be hurt, it could have been so much good with a prance of writing. But however, like I said, it felt too rushed. And that's going to be the end of the video. Huge shout out to these fine people right here who left a few comments onto one of my videos. And keep in mind, guys, if you like a shout out throughout any of your YouTube channels to promote, all you have to do is like, comment, and subscribe. So bear in mind that there is a little rule I have for the comment section. Go into precise detail of how this video felt to you and how you see Borderlands now. It cannot be one or two words only, because if you're willing to do that, I'm not going to put you onto the list. That's just fair, okay? I'm Sure Fry Badoo, and I'll talk to you guys later.